Hey dear friends, welcome back again. So happy you popped over again to see what I am up to today. For everyone who is new here, welcome. My name is Yanni and I hope you enjoy what you see. And if you do, I hope you take a little bit of inspiration with you. For everyone here who is not subscribed to my channel, of course, I hope you will click the red subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, and of course, hit the bell so you will be notified every time I upload new DIYs. Like I always say, enough talking, and let's jump into today's inspiration. And here you see already what we need for today's DIY. We need, of course, our tumbler tile blocks. We have here always my container with everything inside. I hope you have also a very easy, simple container where you can place all your DIY supplies. In. If you don't have a big craft room, of course, I have here just my marker, scissors, brushes, everything I need, my mud pots, my twine, and of course, my wood glue. Of course, you can use hot glue, but be careful, especially also with this DIY, what we're going to make. And of course, we're going to have some paint at your choice. I have here my old saucer with an old piece of kitchen towel, which is wet. And these are the main things we need for this DIY. What we're going to make, we are going to make a scarecrow tray. I know it's a little bit early, but I am always a fall and a winter girl, so I am always loving DIYs for that, and I am already feeling it a little bit coming. I know it's only May, June when you see this, but I don't care. I just love it, so I hope you give this one also a try. First, what we're going to do, we're going to build our scarecrow, and we are going to build it up from under until the top. So we're going to start with the feet. We're going to take two blocks of two. We do some glue inside, and we place this on top. We do some glue on this side and place it on top. Squeeze it, make a straight line. We do here the same, place it on the side, squeeze it, and wipe away the glue, like this. And be sure every time when you do a wipe your glue, make sure that you have still a straight line. We have to get our glue from the table. Now we're going to do the second part of the feet. And we do the same again. We do some glue on this side, place it against each other, do some glue. And place it against each other, and again you're going to squeeze it, and we're going to give it a couple of minutes drying. So what we're going to do, we're going to place two of them this side, but be sure that you have the smallest sides above, so on the top, so don't flat this way but this way. I'm going to do some glue on the underside over here, and I'm going to place this one over here, and make sure that you have them in a straight line. We do here the same, over here, and we're going to place this one on this side, and again, give it a little bit of pressure. Here the same also, make sure that you have a straight line on the top, and we're going to wipe away the glue. And we're going to give it a couple of minutes drying. In the meantime, while these two are drying, we're going to get three blocks. And again, three blocks. Nope, I already have four. So we're going to do on one, on two, some glue, on this one, and on this one. And very easy, place it on the side. Place this one against each other, and this one. And give it a little bit of pressure again, this one on the side, this one against it, and this one over here. And again, squeeze it and press it together and give it a couple of minutes rest again. This DIY, you can dream at the ending. let's give it some couple of minutes rest. Press it, make a straight line. I'm sorry about that, but that's just how the DIY is going. So we gave it a couple of minutes. We do some glue on the tops. And we're going to place both of them together, squeeze it and fill in the open gaps. That's why we only wait a couple of minutes. And I am feeling with my fingers, and I see already that one of the blocks, this one is a little bit smaller than this one. Make sure that you have one side always straight. So you can better leave this one a little bit over. Then, but always make sure that one is straight, because this one will be placed together for the body. So always make sure that one side is at least straight. So we gave also this a couple of minutes. What we're going to do, we do some glue on this side, and we're going to place it over here. Not really in the middle, a little bit off the middle. And we do here the same, but of course you can choose anywhere you like. And I'm going to give a little bit on the side, over here, and this one. And I'm going to give it some pressure. And I'm going to let this dry also. So you see already, we have now kind of an underpiece for our scarecrow. We are going to get my second mat, and I'm going to do carefully place it over here and make sure that everything can dry on its own. We are going to get now 11 blocks, and we're going to place them on the side. So not flat on the table, but on the side. This will be a lot of pieces on the side. So we have already 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And we have already 10. And what we're going to do, we do very easy. We do some glue. We place it on the side again. And we row this together. Just do in the middle a little glue. Not too much, or else it comes over out of every piece. And with me, that's not straight, because I am always using too much glue. But don't do it the way I do, just use a little less. And we do number 10, and number 11 is the closure up. Just going to squeeze it, and we're going to make a straight line. You can use I call it a metal hook, but it is carpenter's square. Someone left me a comment, and I don't remember, but I think you already know what I mean. If you like to use it for make straight lines, just go ahead. I always do it this way. I'm going to give it a couple of minutes rest. So, and in the meantime, well, the first one of 11 blocks is drying, we're going to make a second row of 11 blocks, and we do the same. We just row them very easy together this way. And I only do two rows, because I don't want to have my scarecrow too high, because or else my tray also will be too high. But of course, you can change up the numbers at your own preference. If you like that a little better, higher, or maybe different, just change it up. This is only just an inspiration. You can do, of course, everything you like. And I give it a little bit of the rustic scarecrow, but you can give it also a glam look, your scarecrow. So you don't have to do the rustic look I always do, or maybe most of the time I do a little bit creamy. So don't do it if you don't like it. Only take the example and just make it at your own taste. I'm going to let this dry also a couple of minutes only. So I gave it a couple of minutes. I'm going to lay it on the side, and I'm going to glue both of them together. I also have to give the last one a little bit of glue, because or else he doesn't glue nicely the way I want to have it. I'm going to work away my open gaps, and I'm going to squeeze it and let it dry in before we're going to glue it on the underside. So now we have the body of the, at least the middle piece, and I was thinking to gluing it, but I was totally forgotten that we need to paint it still. So of course we're going to leave this also apart and place it aside. So now we have two pieces. You have this piece, and if everything is correctly, you have this one. Now we're going to go for the face, and we're going to do 6 blocks, and we're going to place them on the side again. We have already 3, 4, 5, and 6, and we do another one. This is already 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we're going to do some glue, and we roll also this 6 together. And this is number 4 and number 5, and number 6 is of course the closure up. We do here number 1,
and number 2 and number 3 and number 4 and number 5. And again, also here is number 6, the closure up. Squeeze it, make a straight line. I'm sorry, I already, for me, my health is already a little bit like the fall season. I already am really need to cough. But of course, I'm going to let this dry. In a moment, we're going to glue them together. So we are going to turn them over and we're going to do some glue on the top side. And make sure that you have all the blocks. And we're going to place them this way together. Of course, you see already, I have open gaps. And that's not what we like. So we're going to carefully press them a little together until one piece like this. And now we already have again another piece done of our scarecrow. What we're going to do, we're going to now 2 times 3. And another one. And we're going to do some glue again, also in the biggest part. Place it together. Oh, whoa. You see where this one, and place it together, and this one. And then we're going to squeeze it again, squeeze it, and we're going to give it a couple of minutes dry time. Now we're going to, because make sure that you have them with the smaller side on top. So here a small here, and make sure that you do some glue on the ending and on this side. And then we're going to row them until one block. Give it some pressure and press it down. And we're going to let this dry also. In the meantime, while this is drying, we're going to get 10 blocks. And place them also on the side. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 and number 10. And we're going to do this the same, repeating what we did, only now with 10 blocks. And we row them very easy together. And like I tell everyone every time in my DIYs, if you don't like this step by step, I totally understand. You can skip forward, but of course you also, maybe this is not your cup of tea and this is not your channel, because I always love to do it step by step, and I know it takes longer and it takes very much of your time. But for everyone who enjoys it to see how it is made, and especially how it is not perfectly made, because I make so many mistakes, and that's DIYing also. DIYing is not that everything is going smoothly and is very goes always right, because most of the time, at least with me, it is not going right. So I change up many times. So this is already 1 of 10. So we have here 3 pieces of 2 together. We have 1 of 10. Now we're going to make 2 blocks of 2. And then we have his head. And this is 1. Place it together. And this is 1. And we place this 1 also together. Over here, squeeze it. And we're going to let this rest a couple of minutes. So now we're going to build his head. We have the 1 of 10. We have the 1 of the double up, and this will be on the top. So we do some glue on this side. And we're going to turn it and we do some glue on this side. Of course, on each block, place it down. We're going to place it in the over here. And now we're going to only do some glue on this two at the ending. And this way, you're going to squeeze it. And now we're going to place it against here. And make sure that you have a nice straight line. This way. And now we're going to let this dry. So now we have all our 4 pieces of our scarecrow. I'm going to use, this is a little bit of the gold color. This is a little bit of the darker orange. And I have brown and a little bit of the gray, dark gray. But Like I told you, you can choose any color you like. You can even make a snowman out of it if you want to do it for the Christmas season. But I'm just choosing a little bit for the fall because I also love fall. I am a Christmas girl and this is a Christmas channel, but also with little touches of other seasons. So if everything is correctly, I place this aside. You have one piece from a six block, two times six blocks like this one. You have the feet. And you have the middle piece is 2 times 11. And you have the head, which is 2 times 3, and 1 of 10, and 4 blocks on top of each other. So very easy. And you can choose any color for your paint. So I'm going to do my middle piece in the orange color. And of course, I just do a little bit of orange over here. And of course, very easy. This is just simple paint when you also use if you are making how you call it, we call it schilderijen, you call it paintings. So at least I'm going to give it a nice color of orange, and I like because it's a little bit of the darker orange. Of course, you don't have to do the middle piece, but I always say when it's not totally fitting, because blocks are not always fitting, then you can see which what you did paint and what you didn't paint. So I don't like that. So I'm going to do all the piece in the color. So now I am going to make the head in a little bit of the darker gray, not totally black, but a little bit of the darker gray. But if you like black better, or maybe brown, it is also fine. So I'm going to take my time also for this one. So now I'm going to do his legs and of course a little piece of the trousers. And I'm going to do this one in the brown and only the under pieces in the black. Of course, I should have waited to glue this to on the underside. But of course, I'm going to do it very carefully, make this black. And I'm going to make this brown. So now I'm going to do the face and a little bit of the creamy color. So I'm going to do, and I try to give it a little bit of a distressed look. So it is not totally full painted. I'm just going to try to get, let a little bit of the wood still come through. But of course, like I told you earlier, do whatever you think is right. So I'm going to do his face now. So now I did get out of my stash 4 wooden buttons. You can buy them anywhere. And I'm going to give them a little bit of the gold color. And it is, yeah, it's a little bit yellow, a little bit gold. It looks strange if you have it on your pencil, but I hope at the end, it will look nice. So I'm going to paint all four of them, because it is a front side and a back side will be the same. So you can use it on both ways because it's a tray. So we will see how both sides have to be equal. So I'm just going to paint all four of them. So now I painted all the pieces and I was just working a little bit with my pencil and try to look for if I could make a little face, because you don't have to be with me if you want to make beautiful faces for on top of your DIYs. I am not a great painter, so I made a little sketch and of course with my pencil, and now I'm going to color it in, and just for me it is very nice. But of course, do your own twist on the face, because maybe you do some googly eyes or maybe something else. But I'm just did paint it. I'm going to do the eyes black. The nose will be in the orange color, and this will be also in the black, and I do it with a marker. So I show you in a moment how my face is turned out. And here you see how my face turned out. And of course I have on the other side the same, because we do it double up. And you see, I just did it very simple. A little bit of the black eyes, a little dot of the back side of my brush. At least I always use the back side of the brush. Just dip it in a little in the paint and just a little dab on here. I keep it myself very easy and simple. And of course, what we're going to do now, we're going to get the middle piece, his coat, and we're going to glue 2 gold buttons on top this way. And then we're going to do also the back side, But we do it just with a little bit of hot wood glue. You can do it also with some hot glue. So we have now our buttons, of course, on the front side and the back side. Now I'm going to take my hat and I'm going to make a simple kind of square over here in the orange color. At least I choose the orange color. And over here, and just give it a little bit of stitching on the side, so it looks a little bit like an old piece of that you made your hat. So I don't know how I explain it. I hope I explain it right, but you see in a moment what I mean. So I'm just going to get my a little orange color, and I'm just going to do a little bit on my brush, not too much. And I'm going to do here a little kind of a square. First, I'm going to make a kind of a silhouette where I want to have it, and then I'm going to make a rough kind of a square over here, and then I'm going to do a little bit paint extra, but I don't want to have it too much paint. So over here, and I'm going to make a square as much as I can. And then I'm going to let this dry. And of course I do also on the other side one. So you see I made a little square on this side and on the other side. What I'm going to do, I'm going to get a very small brush. And I'm going to keep it lightly through the gold color, because I'm going to make a couple of stitches around it over here. I'm going to make little lines just over here and over here, so it looks like it is sewed together like this. I do the other side also. So now we're going to do the bottom, at least where he is standing on, and I'm a little bit scared that I made my scarecrow a little too high, even because I want to have a kind of a little tray on top. So I think maybe the feet will go away, but we will see. I think I have more than enough than only the body and the head and his face. So we will see. First, we're going to make the underside, the stand where he's standing on. And then we're going to make the tray for on top. And I'm going to do number 10. And number 11 is, of course, the closure up. Squeeze it from within. And that's what I mean with DIYing. I never can say how many blocks you will use, because I always change my mind. I never know how it will turn out. I have then something in my head and I really have no idea how it is turning out. So, but we will see, and we're going to work with it. And the best thing is, I make the mistakes already, and you can easily do it in one piece, and you don't have to make the mistakes. But maybe you like a higher tray, then you still can use it. But I think for me, he will be too high. So we're going to squeeze it, and we're going to press it, and we make a straight line and give it a couple of minutes rest. Of course, I'm also wiping away the glue, and we're going to give it a couple of minutes. So now we're going to place one on the side. We do some glue and we make a nice bottom out of it. Again, place it together and this way, and we're going to work away our gaps, and we're going to let this dry. So in the meantime, while this is drying, we're going to get four blocks and double two. And we're going to do the tops, because I think it looks gives a little bit like a high-end look on the side. We don't want to that it looks cheap, but at least I always think you can better give it a high-end look, so it looks much better in your home. And this is number 4, and now only these two. And this one, we're going to squeeze it. And we're going to squeeze this one over here. And this one the same. And again, make sure that you have a straight line. And we're going to give it also a couple of minutes. So now we're going to place this one in the middle. We place this two over here, this one over here, and we place them on the side and on this side. And you see already this one is not totally, see already, he's not totally glued together. So we give it a little glue. That's why I show you also, if you have something like this, don't let it discourage you, because you can easily glue it together again. It doesn't matter. So we do some glue on all sides of our plank. And over here. And over here. And this is also not totally dried up. So also this can fall apart, but don't worry about it. If it does, it doesn't matter, because you easily glue it together again. And this way. And we're going to place it down. I do it carefully this way. And now we're going to place this one over here, this one over here. And we do some glue a little on the sides over here and this one. So. And we're going to place it over here. Of course, I need to do this one also. And it's not really an exactly fitting, but we will do. And have a little bit of pressure on the side. And of course, we still need to do this one a little. And you saw me already doing it on the wrong side. That's why I do it on this side. It's much better. I don't know why I did the other side. But you know already, sometimes DIYing is also trying and see how it goes. And again, we have a nice border around it. And we're going to let this dry in. You see already, I have now the sizes of the tray. And I'm going to do also 11 pieces here, 11 here. And we're going to make the same like we did with the bottom. Also these two, we are do placing on the side, do some glue over here. And we're going to place them together. And now we're going to make also the border for 2x4. So very easy. You place it aside, you do 2x4 pieces. And over here, and you do 2x2. And you glue them together and you make your border again around your leg. So now the tray and the bottom are drying. We're going to place them on the side and we're going to glue now our scarecrow together. Of course, we are going to start with the face on top of here, because if I would do the legs, you see already, he would be very big. This is not going to work, at least not if you want to make this scarecrow on its own. It's totally fine, but for the idea I have for it, it doesn't work. It really doesn't work. So I'm going to turn this one over and I'm going to glue this one on top of here. Always look which side fitting the best. So I'm going to do some glue in the middle over here. And we're going to place this one also in the middle and give it a little bit of pressure. And this way. And now we're going to do some glue on top of here in the middle. And we're going to place the head on top. I have to look for if I have it in the way I want to have it, or maybe this way. And of course, we also place this one in the middle. And we're going to let this dry in. And this needs to dry at least for 1/2 hour. In the meantime, while our scarecrow is drying, we are going to paint the bottom and the top. And I use the creamy color because I already used some coloring. So I keep it a little bit neutral. So I'm going to go for the creamy color, but you can go for any color you like. I won't bore you with painting because I think you already know how to paint your pieces. So of course we do it a little faster. So both of our pieces, the tray and of course the bottom, is painted, and I did them on the piece of kitchen towel because I don't want to scratch my paint. So I use a lot of kitchen towel because I don't like when pieces are really broken off, at least not when you don't want to. If you like totally distressed, it's totally fine. I'm going to first do the tray side. I'm going to turn it upside down like this, and I'm going to make sure that I let it dry really well, because here in the middle I will turn over my scarecrow and I will glue him inside of the middle of this tray. So I'm going to get my scarecrow and I'm going to do some glue on the top over here. And of course you can also do a little bit of hot glue on the sides if you want to, that it dries immediately, because I always use my wood glue, but sometimes it's easier that you do also a little dots of hot glue. So it doesn't matter how you do it, just do it the way you like it. I'm going to place this over here and I'm going to place it in the middle. Of course, I have to keep it in place for a little moment until it is sucked in, and not let it loose already. So I'm going to look for if I have it in the middle, and then we're going to let it dry at least for an hour and a half. So now our scarecrow is dried in, and he's not fully dried because he still needs to go a little moment. But I'm going to glue it also now in the middle of the bottom. So I'm going to do some glue on the underside of our scarecrow, and I'm going to turn it around, and then I hope that my tray stays on top of my scarecrow, but you never know, it can decide to fall apart. So we are going to turn this over like this, and we're going to place this one in the middle, and we're going to keep it in place for a little moment until it is dried in. Of course, I take my time for this at least 1.5 hours. You see in a moment the quick impression.
And you see finally my quick impression of my Tumblr Tower Blocks Scarecrow 2-tier tray. And I'm so happy how he turned out. I really had no idea. I just did something and I think it looks very nice. I really hope you give this one a try, with legs or without legs. It's your choice. Of course, I did without. Of course, everyone who is new here, I hope you enjoy what you saw. And if you do, I hope you will click the red subscribe button, give me a thumbs up and hit the bell so you will be notified every time I upload new DIYs. And everyone who is here and only love to watch, I hope you had fun watching. And do you want to see more DIYs? Come on over to my description box. There you find the link for our DIY channels. Everyone, have an amazing day, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.